Hello, this is Dr. Mercola, and one of the keys to achieving optimal health and a highly functioning immune system is to make sure you optimize your gut flora. Now, I know for some of you that may sound relatively odd, but the number of bacteria in your gut outnumber your own body cells by 10 to 1, and it really is a foundational key to improving not only your immune system, but your entire health. It really is one of the most basic strategies you could implement to improve your health. So with this understanding, it's important to realize that eating sugars and processed foods and many of the grains tend to encourage the growth of pathogenic bacteria, yeast, and fungi, which will then inhibit the growth of beneficial bacteria, which tend to support your immune system. Now, additionally, that's one of the ways that sugar acts, is it is a inhibits the growth of the good bacteria and feeds the bad bacteria. But additionally, sugar can have direct effects on your immune system, as it can decrease the activity of your neutrophils or your white blood cells, and those are responsible for producing all the immune cellular components of fighting infection. Now, in fact, it's been shown that even simple carbohydrates other than sugar when these are tested, they show significantly decreased capacity of your white blood cells to engulf bacteria after you eat sugar. And in fact, the greatest effects seem to occur between 1 and 2 hours after you eat that carbohydrate, sugar or grain, and the values are typically significantly below fasting controls for up to 5 hours after you eat them. So please, if you are sick, the last thing you ever want to do is to eat any sugar. It will literally impair your body's ability to recover from that illness, and you're really putting yourself behind the eight ball when you do that. So if you're going to have sugar, make sure you are healthy. Because if you are suffering from any acute infections, it will likely make you much worse and increase your recovery time, or possibly even allow the infection you're currently experiencing to progress to a more serious one like pneumonia. Now, another critical factor is sleep. Ideally, you want to get about at least 7 hours, and maybe 8 to 9, and the timing of the sleep is also crucial. You want to get to bed well before midnight, preferably if you can around 10 or so, and then sleep the 7 to 9 hours. It's also important to make sure that you do not have any exposure to outside lights, as this will disrupt your body's ability to produce melatonin, and melatonin is certainly very useful for the functioning of your immune system and your body's ability to control cancer. So even any light coming through can impair this ability. Now, another phenomenal tool is exercise, but you have to make sure you don't overdo it, because if you have an acute infection, you don't want to do an intense workout because it will probably make you worse. Just exercise very lightly. But if you're exercising regularly, you actually increase your body's temperature, and that's one of the ways that you can fight infection, is by making your body temperature higher. That's one of the benefits. That's why you have a fever many times when you're infection, because that higher temperature helps eliminate those infections. Now, stress can be another powerful influence on your body's ability to succumb to these illnesses. So you really want to make sure you have some really good strategies that can address the stress once you have it. And some of the strategies that people use would be prayer, meditation, and some of the energy psychology tools like EFT or emotional freedom technique. So these are some of the important essential foundational steps of really providing the resources your body will need to have a healthy immune system. Now, if you wanted to extend it beyond that, especially if you were suffering from an acute infection, here are some of the time-honored ones that can be used to support your immune system. These would be vitamin C, which is a very potent antioxidant, and when you're using this, you want to make sure you use a natural form, not a synthetic one. Natural ones would be ones from acerola, which contains other associated micronutrients which help support the vitamin C. Oregano oil is also useful. The higher the carvacrol concentration, the more effective it is. Propolis is another useful one. That's, of course, from a bee product. It's a bee resin, and propolis is also the richest source of caffeic acid and apigenin, two very important compounds that help support your immune system. Another one would be olive leaf extract, and ancient Egyptians and Mediterranean cultures used it for a variety of health-promoting uses, and is widely known as a natural, non-toxic immune system supporter. Now, there's another exciting emerging supplement that can be a very helpful adjunct to supporting your immune system, and that is mushrooms. You know, there's over 300 different species of mushrooms that are now thought to have potential for promoting human health. And the evidence continues to emerge, confirming how mushrooms' proteins, their trace minerals, their polysaccharides, amino acids, and fiber promote overall health. These and other compounds found in mushrooms are now believed to provide a number of benefits, such as promoting normal cellular growth, protecting against environmental stressors, supporting your body's normal detoxification process, supporting the most important healthy gut flora, and promoting optimal digestion. Now, most people view mushrooms as the fleshy, spore-bearing, fruiting body of a fungus, like grows in the forest or on your lawn, and is typically produced above the ground. However, most of the magic in the mushroom is actually in their very complex root structure that you don't see. It grows below ground. And this root structure is called the mycelium. And it actually can have up to 95% of the mushroom's total biomass. Now, the mycelium is a vast network of living cells covering much of the Earth's surface. And what about mushrooms that makes them so potentially valuable to support your health and support your immune system? Well, that would be the beta-glucans and proteoglycans that are the primary biologically active compounds in mushrooms in their fruiting bodies and the mycelia that support your immune system and actually support the immune system of animals, too. Beta-glucans are chains of polysaccharides and proteoglycans and they're special proteins, and they're often found in connective tissue. Now, the beta-glucans found in mushrooms are very large and complex long-chain molecules. And what sets certain beta-glucans apart are their unique side-branching patterns. And just like a lock and key, the beta-glucan compounds in mushrooms must fit perfectly with your cellular receptor sites to support your immune system. So now that you have some information that suggests that the mushrooms it may be a benefit to supporting your immune system, how do you find a good mushroom product? Well, let me give you some tips. Most mushroom products you'll find on the store shelves are made from extracts. So the first thing is to make sure you look for a product that's made from the whole mushroom. Just like eating a fresh vegetable with its fiber and natural nutrients intact, which is the preferred way to get those nutrients. It's no different with mushrooms. And when you extract certain bioactive compounds from mushrooms, such as these important beta-glucans and polysaccharides, you tend to leave behind these crucial enzymes, coenzymes, and chelated mineral activators. Now, these very valuable compounds actually support the mushroom's bioactivity and how your body ultimately receives benefit from the total mushroom complex. So you have to be really careful because the extraction process can also damage many of the bioactive enzymes and proteins. And here's something else I absolutely must mention, in that highly concentrated mushroom extracts can bring the potential for potentially serious and unintended consequences. As powerful as they can be, an overload of certain compounds and isolated extracts may actually shut down some important feedback loops that your body depends upon. So another key to look for is how the company actually produces the mushrooms. The best approach is something called solid-state fermentation. So just look for that if you're selecting a mushroom product. So hopefully, these are some key useful tips that you can use to support your immune system, because the key in all of this, of course, is to take control of your health.